Hey there, Gold Rush fans. Buckle up, because today we're diving into a story filled with grit, tension, and one surprising phone call that could change everything. It's about a man backed into a corner, a friendship tested by time, and the relentless pursuit of gold. Rick Ness, a seasoned miner with a reputation for facing the toughest odds, finds himself at his breaking point. His mining crew is down to one green recruit, Morgan Lauren, who's barely cut her teeth in the unforgiving world of gold mining. With his key team member Z missing in action, Rick's operation teeters on the brink of collapse. But when all seems lost, Rick does the unthinkable. He picks up the phone and calls his old boss, Parker Schnabel, to ask for a favor. And let me tell you, Parker's response will leave you stunned. Picture this, the sun blazing down as Morgan struggles with an ancient, rented loader. This isn't just any machine, it's a relic, a clunky beast kicking up dirt and dust in every direction. No air-conditioned cab, no modern amenities, just raw determination. Then, disaster strikes, a flat tire halts operations entirely. Rick's frustration boils over. The loader, unreliable at best, has become the anchor dragging his operation to the depths. Desperate, Rick's mind races for solutions. He remembers Parker Schnabel, a man who once mentored him in mining's brutal art. Maybe, just maybe, Parker has the spare equipment that could save Rick's season. But here's the twist, Rick and Parker's relationship isn't exactly warm and fuzzy. Rick left Parker's team years ago after a series of heated disagreements. This call could go either way. As Rick pulls up to Parker's expanded mining site, the tension is palpable. Parker greets him with a half-smile and a teasing comment about Rick's unexpected visit. Beneath the banter, old wounds linger, but so does mutual respect. Rick lays his cards on the table. He needs a loader, or his season is done before it even begins. Parker, surprisingly generous, walks Rick through his new $2 million equipment yard. He offers Rick whatever he needs, no strings attached, at least for now. This isn't just an act of kindness, it's a moment of reconciliation. Both men know the stakes, and Parker's trust gives Rick a glimmer of hope. But this is only the beginning. Rick's challenges at Duncan Creek will push him to his limits. At Duncan Creek, the hits keep coming. A broken water pump brings operations to a grinding halt for 4 agonizing days. The cost? $20,000 in lost potential gold. But when Rick secures a new high-tech pump, hope flickers back to life. The team's relief is short-lived. The pump, weighing over 2 tons, must be carefully positioned on the site's steep, treacherous terrain. One wrong move could spell disaster. The crew works tirelessly, inching the massive machine into place. Finally, they fire it up, only for it to sputter out moments later, an empty fuel tank. It's a costly oversight, but they quickly refuel and press on. By week's end, the new pump helps the crew recover some of their lost momentum, yielding $155,000 in gold. It's not the jackpot Rick hoped for, but it's enough to keep them afloat. Rick's story isn't just about digging for gold, it's about resilience, teamwork, and leaning on old connections when the chips are down. His unexpected reunion with Parker Schnabel shows that even in a cutthroat industry like gold mining, trust and camaraderie can pave the way forward. As Rick's crew battles breakdowns and setbacks, their determination shines through. Every nugget of gold they unearth is a testament to their grit and ingenuity. And while the future remains uncertain, one thing is clear: Rick Ness isn't giving up anytime soon. So, what do you think, folks? Is gold mining worth the risks and relentless pressure? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more incredible stories from the world of Gold Rush. Until next time, keep digging for your dreams.